Good morning once again, everyone. I am Chad Holmes. It is our number two of the Chad Holmes Show on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. The time is 9:07, currently mostly cloudy skies, but a little sunshine peeking through, temperature of 21 degrees in downtown Wausau. Again, hopefully you had a fantastic weekend. Maybe not as good a weekend as Ian Welsh had, but still a good weekend nevertheless. And it's good to be back here as we go into the latter portion of February. Coming up in just a little bit, we'll talk some sports. But I want to let people know real quickly before we go any further that it's going to be a very busy week of high school sports here on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. In fact, myself and Tom Weaver, I'm getting Tom working quite a bit this week as well. Because tonight, tomorrow, and Thursday, we have a pair of games, either live here on Bull Falls Radio, over the airwaves, or live on our Sports 2 stream, both on BullFallsRadio.com and the Civic Media app. Tonight, Tom will be in Edgar as the Edgar Wildcats host the Marathon Red Raiders. Marathon is the number one ranked team in the state. Favorite right now, I would say, in the Division 4 playoffs. But Tom will be in Edgar for that big one between longtime rivals. And coverage will begin with the pregame show at 7 and the opening tip at 7:15, live right here on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. Tonight, I will be heading to Wisconsin Rapids as the Newman Catholic Cardinals will travel to Assumption for a Merrillwood Conference South Division matchup. That game can be heard live starting at 7 o'clock on the Sports 2 stream of BullFallsRadio.com and the Civic Media app. Again, if you go to BullFallsRadio.com, what you'll see is right now a listing of our show that's on the air, which of course is my show. It will then show you the next 3 hours of shows that are coming up, Matt and Air on Air, and then the Todd Alba Show. And then right below that, it'll say Play Sports 2 and Play Sports 3. All you have to do is hit Play Sports 2, and you'll be able to hear tonight at 7 o'clock live Newman Catholic boys basketball at Assumption. Also, you can go to the Civic Media app if you have not downloaded it. Free, the free Civic Media app. Download it. And then the fifth station down is Bull Falls Radio. Open that up, and you'll see Primary Stream, which is what's on the air. Then Sports 2 and Sports 3. Just click on Sports 2, and you'll be able to hear it as well. So again, this week we have games on our Sports 2 stream tonight, tomorrow, and Thursday. And if you want to hear those games, make sure that you have either the Civic Media app, which, again, I encourage you to get. You can listen to all the Civic Media radio stations, including Bull Falls Radio, and or you can listen on our website, bullfallsradio.com. So tonight, Marathon at Edgar, 7 o'clock with Tom Weaver, live on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online on the app. You know the drill. And then 7 o'clock, Newman Catholic at Assumption on the Sports 2 stream of BullFallsRadio.com and the Civic Media app. Tomorrow night, the Central Wisconsin Storm in action. The Storm in a sectional semifinal. 2 wins away from a trip to the state tournament. The Storm take on Hayward, 6:50 p.m. pregame, 7 o'clock faceoff tomorrow night, live here on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices by searching WXCO and the Civic Media app. And also tomorrow night, Marathon girls basketball. They open up the playoffs in a regional quarterfinal against Ladysmith. Tom will have that one starting at 6:45 on the Sports 2 stream of BullFallsRadio.com and the Civic Media app. So, again, that's just the start of the week. We have lots of action Thursday and Friday as well. Hopefully Saturday, if any of our girls' basketball teams can make it to a regional final. The time is 9:11. Time to say hello and good morning again to our in-studio engineer, producer Ian Welsh. Ian, good morning.
Good morning, Chad.
And again, you had a big weekend. We talked about it a bit earlier in the program, but for those who joined us late, you had your big production of The Drowsy Chaperone from the Wausau Community Theater at the Venega Theater at UWSP at the Wausau campus. And four shows, one on Thursday, one on Friday, then two more on Saturday. I had the chance to go over and see it on Saturday afternoon. And got to say again, I thought you were fantastic. I thought your castmates were fantastic. I thought the set was terrific. I thought the musicians were stellar. Really, you guys put it all together.
Absolutely. It was such a fun experience. And definitely, it's like we talked about in the show, is that a theater is like, for many of us, it's like an escape from reality, because reality can sometimes be very
In a good way. Some people go escaping from reality in a bad way, but
that is
a good way.
Yes, absolutely. And it gives you some nice songs to carry when you feel sad, and it makes you feel. It gives you hope, and that's the main thing I like about a theater, is that, you know, even if you know how it's going to end, it still gives you hope that things will turn out good in the end. Absolutely.
And something else, again, to mention, the fact that here in Central Wisconsin, we have lots of different opportunities to be involved in the arts in some way.
Indeed.
Whether it's being a performer, being a patron at the Grand Theater for these Broadway touring shows, but you got the opportunities to actually be involved, to be involved in community theater, to be involved in some of the other theater groups that are around. You got the high school shows that are going on. And we touched on the fact that it was such an important aspect for you to be able to grow as a person, to be able to
Absolutely. To
come out and be able to, you know, be more open and not be in a shell as much, like you said, you were as a young person. And I think we need to underline that if there are folks out there tuned in right now that think, you know, I can't do that, there's no way I could do that, I think that
you don't have to have experience to be in a theater. It's just about, you know, making new friends and having fun and getting to step into somebody else's shoes and be a different character. And characters can transform you in some way. Like, you might find something very similar about the character you're portraying that applies to your own life, and you take that and you build on that, and it gives you something to relate to and something to hope for. And I think that's a very transformative experience. That's why I like to, you know, be these different characters, because it's like you get to play someone that's like close to your personality, or like somebody who's the exact opposite of your personality. Like, someday I hope to be a villain in a show, which would definitely be a huge step for me, because I'm not used to being a villain. So that would definitely be a fun acting experience for me. I'd like to try someday.
Where did this production rank in terms of your experiences? Was this up near the top?
Well, I'd say this was definitely near the top of the list. I mean, the acting and singing and dancing in the show is just top notch, and it was really, like I said before, it was really awesome to do it all over again, because I did this a production once in high school, and it was very, well, it was an interesting experience, because it's more of an adult show, so it was very interesting to have a high school put that on. But this time around, it felt more appropriate, because we were all older and we actually got a lot more of the jokes better. So this time around, I say it was a better experience to do it this time around.
What part did you play the first time?
I was just in the ensembles. I thought it was a lot of things.
Were great. Yeah. I mean, they really added to it as well. I thought that whenever the ensemble was part of it and coming out as part of either the singing and the dancing, I thought it was outstanding. Well, what's next?
Without the ensemble, there is no show.
What's next for you?
Well, I know that there's there's another theater company in Wausau. It's the River and Woods Theater Company. Tonight and tomorrow, they're having auditions for a very unusual murder mystery show. It's called Noses Off. It's kind of like a show within a show within a rehearsal. So it's basically like there's these actors who are portraying characters in a show, and the whole thing is just about like the behind the scenes backstage experience of what goes on when the actors are not on a stage. Like, there's a whole bunch of costuming mishaps, there's a bunch of props mishaps, there's a bunch of showmances between different characters of the show. Like, some characters are dating one character while kind of having an affair with another character in the show, and it's just a funny show.
Are you trying out?
I'm thinking about it. I just have to make sure that I've rested up enough, which thankfully yesterday I had a nice day of rest, so I'm feeling a little bit better, but I'm thinking of auditioning for it, but I don't know which character I'm going to audition for. But I would probably check it out just for the experience. If I don't get in the show, it's okay. Just,
right.
Well, it's always fun to audition because you never know what's going to happen at these auditions.
Absolutely. Again, congratulations on a wonderful production.
Thank you. Really enjoyed
it. I hope everybody else had the opportunity to see it as well. And again, next time you hear about these shows, take advantage and go out and see your friends and your neighbors, and you'll be surprised at how high the quality is. It was a very...
Indeed, you will.
Yep, very, very good show indeed. Good production. The time is 9:18. More to come. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 12:30. Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, BowFallsRadio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app, 22 degrees in downtown Wausau, again broadcasting live from downtown, the corner of Washington Street and North 3rd Street from our Bow Falls studios. The time is 9:21. Again, don't forget tomorrow morning, if you join me usually between 8 and 10 a.m., make sure you join me again tomorrow as a guest host on Up North News Radio. Pat Kreitlow is off this week, so I substitute guest hosted earlier today. Had Jimmy Cuska, the Civic Media Sports Director, American Hispanic Association's Tony Gonzalez, and Civic Media News Director Terry Bell this morning. If you missed the show, you can go to Up North News and the podcast page, either on the website or wherever you get your podcast to listen to those programs. Tomorrow morning at 6:20, we'll be joined by Nancy Stensel. Of course, Nancy, very active politically here in central Wisconsin, working with the Democrats, trying to help gain votes in the 7th Congressional District. And then, speaking of the 7th, we'll be joined by candidate Kyle Kilborn, one of the two Democratic candidates that is attempting to unseat incumbent Congressman Tom Tiffany. So Kyle Kilborn at 7:35 tomorrow morning as well. So 6:20, Nancy Stensel, 7:35, Kyle Kilborn, our guest tomorrow on Up North News Radio, here on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Also throughout the state of Wisconsin on stations in the Civic Media Network. And you can tune in as well on the Civic Media app. In the last hour, we were talking about the response or lack thereof when it came to the death of Alexei Navalny. Again, the opposition leader in Russia, the biggest thorn in the side of Vladimir Putin. And mentioned the fact that neither Ron Johnson nor Donald Trump had said anything about that.
So we have no idea how he died? Well, is that correct?
At this point, what happened on Friday was we saw Navalny on a video as he was in court. And then he was back in jail and he was walking around the grounds and he collapsed and died. And that's all we know at this point. Wow. But we now have heard from the former president, Donald Trump.
Of course we have.
Donald Trump has put out a statement on his Truth Social, and he has used Alexei Navalny's death as a means to further his own political agenda, commenting for the first time about the Russian opposition leader since his death last week. Trump, in a post on his own Truth Social site, used Navalny's death to discuss his opinions on Democratic politicians and policies here in the United States. Not really talking about what happened to Navalny and what it meant in terms of a tragedy for the country of Russia and for the world that the leading opposition political figure in that country was perhaps allegedly murdered by the leader of that country. Oh. Trump asserted that Navalny's death made Trump himself, and again, he makes everything about himself, but yep, that this made Trump more aware of what is happening in the United States, and asserting that America is a nation in decline. We've gone a long way from the shining city on a hill to Donald Trump's America in decline. This is what Donald Trump said on Truth Social. The sudden death of Alexei Navalny has made me The sudden death of Alexei Navalny has made me, Donald Trump, more and more aware of what is happening in our country. And then he gets into his Trumpisms. Yeah. It is a slow, steady progression with crooked, radical left politicians, prosecutors, and judges leading us down a path to destruction.
Do you hear yourself, sir?
Let me finish, then you can comment.
Let me finish
what Trump had to say. Mm-hmm. I know it's hard to sometimes wait when you get outraged by Mr. Trump, but he continued, open borders, rigged elections, and grossly unfair courtroom decisions. Who could we be talking about there, right? Are destroying America, all capital letters. All capital letters. We are a nation in decline, a failing nation. Mega 2024. Again, this is not about Donald Trump. This is about the world. This is about Russia. This is about a politician trying to bring some sense of openness to his country, getting taken out by the leader of that country. It's not about Donald Trump. It's not about America's courtroom decisions that went against Donald Trump. It's all about Trump with him. Yeah. He doesn't look beyond himself. And there has to be a point where you have to look beyond yourself. It's the whole, not the individual.
It's a whole picture.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. So we have now heard from Donald Trump. We are still waiting to hear from Ron Johnson. It would be surprising if his statement, if he makes a statement, is much different in terms of the substance. Maybe the style would be different, because I mean, Trump has been extremely sympathetic to Vladimir Putin, and Ron Johnson has also been extremely sympathetic to Vladimir Putin. Trump has refused at times to publicly comment about Navalny, even before this, and offer his own words of support for the opposition leader. And since launching his latest campaign for president, Trump has been publicly critical of any attempt to provide additional support to Ukraine, much like Ron Johnson, embracing Vladimir Putin on the campaign trail again. Because of Trump's anti-Ukraine stance, congressional Republicans, led by Ron Johnson, have followed his lead by refusing to pass any new aid to Ukraine. So it'll be very interesting to see if that pro-Putin, pro-Russia, anti-Ukrainian wing of the Republican Party backs down at all after this outrage where a opposition leader is maybe killed. And again, there seems to be very little doubt that Putin had attempted to kill him previously. It appears that maybe Putin got him this time. But again, we need to hear from Ron Johnson. We need to hear something from Johnson. Again, he is a senator from the state of Wisconsin. He needs to step up and be heard because, he was one of the leaders just last week in terms of trying to halt any potential aid to Ukraine in their war against Putin and Russia.
Right.
Ron, we need to hear from you today, immediately. The time is 9:28. Going to talk a little sports as the brackets for the boys basketball playoffs came out yesterday morning, I should say. We're going to talk about that and more coming up sports-wise in just a few moments. Next, news, weather, and sports from Civic Media and Bow Falls Radio. I'm Chad Holmes, Chad Holmes Show, Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Central Wisconsin Storm hockey team looks to move one step closer towards the state tournament. The Storm will play host to Hayward in a sectional semifinal. Hear all the exciting action on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, online at bowfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app, starting with pregame show at 6:50 and the opening faceoff at 7 p.m. Storm Hockey on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230 is brought to you by the Cloverbelt Credit Union, Red Robin Restaurant, Sun Printing, Graphic Packaging International, the Wausau West Athletic Department, Menke Automotive, Shine Chiropractic, and Picks and Pieces. It's the Central Wisconsin Storm versus Hayward in a girls' hockey sectional semifinal. Tuesday, starting with the pregame show at 6:50 on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, bowfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. Chad Holmes Show on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bowfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. Again, the time is 9:36. And big week. We just heard a promo in terms of our high school hockey coverage for tomorrow. The Central Wisconsin Storm in the sectional semifinals taking on Hayward. And again, what a interesting bracket it is. The Central Wisconsin Storm, the number two ranked team in the state. The number three ranked team in the state. Hayward, the number four ranked team in the state. And this bracket, so incredibly difficult. You got Superior, number one ranked. They are in a sectional semifinal tomorrow evening, taking on Northern Pines, the number 5 seed. And then you got the number 2 seed Central Wisconsin Storm against the number 3 seed Hayward. Again, this is the bracket of death with three of the top 4 teams in the state rankings all in the same sectional. So that means one of these teams, in all likelihood, of course, if Northern Pines goes on a Cinderella run, they could make it to state. But in all likelihood, one of the top 4 teams in the state from this bracket will go to the state tournament. But two of the top 4 teams in the state, because of the bracket alignment, will not be going to state. So just getting the state out of this bracket could be as difficult as actually winning a state championship once you get there. But tomorrow night, the Storm and the Hayward Hurricanes, the Storm trying to get a little bit of revenge. A year ago in this very same round, Hayward came up north and beat the Storm in the sectional semifinal. A year ago, the game was at the Green Heck Fieldhouse. This year, the Storm will host at the Marathon Park Ice Arena. So we expect it to be a good one tonight. Central Wisconsin Storm and the Hayward Hurricanes tomorrow night, 6:50 pregame, right here on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 12:30. BowFallsRadio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO and on the Civic Media app. Yesterday, the WIAA announced the brackets for the upcoming boys basketball playoffs, as the basketball playoffs on the boys' side will begin next week. But our area teams found their road to state and the Kohl Center yesterday. Central Wisconsin actually represented very well in the brackets. And for a number of years recently, the Wisconsin Valley Conference has not been thought of at the top when it came to Division I. Ever since Stevens Point ended their run with the Hauser boys and Trev Anderson with the back-to-back-to-back state championships, it's been a bit of a rough go for the Valley. But in Division I, Marshfield, the three-time Wisconsin Valley Conference champions, they get a number 1 seed in the bracket. So Marshfield, number 1 seeded, will take on either 16th seeded Wisconsin Rapids or number 17 seeded Chippewa Falls in a regional semifinal. Other teams from our area, the Wausau West Warriors. This shows how difficult this bracket is. Wausau West has had a very good season, well over 500. And yet they're the number 12 seed. They took the number 1 seed Marshfield to overtime just this Friday night and lost in OT in a game that we had here on Bow Falls Radio. But the Warriors, number 12 seeded, and in their first playoff game, a regional semifinal, have to travel to number 5 seeded Kaukauna. Again, that's a week from Friday night, a game that we expect to have live right here on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 12:30. Also in D1, the D.C. Evergreens are seeded number 10. Their first playoff game will be a week from Friday night. They make the long trek to Hudson to take on the Hudson Raiders. D.C.E. number 10 seed, number 7 seed is Hudson. And also in this bracket from the Wisconsin Valley Conference, Stevens Point, the Spanish Panthers, number 2 seeded. So that means Marshfield number 1, Stevens Point number 2. Stevens Point will take on either number 15 Holman or number 18 Appleton West in the first round of the playoffs. Division 2, number 1 seed in the boys basketball side, the Wausau East Lumberjacks. Haven't said that for a long time. It's been a bit of a struggle in boys hoops for a number of years for Wausau East, but the Lumberjacks having a terrific season. Number 1 seed in Division 2 Sectional 1, so that means the Lumberjacks get a first-round bye. They will wait for the winner of the game between number 9-seeded Ashland and number 8-seeded Merrill in their first playoff game. East will host either Merrill or Ashland on Friday night, March the 1st. Also in that bracket, Rhinelander from the Great Northern Conference, number 5-seeded. They will host number 12-seeded Hayward next Tuesday, with the winner advancing to play at number 4-seeded Rice Lake the following Friday. A couple of Great Northern Conference teams will also meet in that D2 bracket. Number 11 Antigo travels to number 6 Medford, with the winner moving on to play at number 3 New Richmond. Division 4 features a lot of Marrowood Conference basketball teams. Marathon in Division 4 Sectional 2, number 1 seed. Marathon will have their first playoff game on Friday, March the 1st, taking on either number 8 seeded Colby or number 9 seeded Crandon. The Crandon will travel to Colby next Tuesday. The winner plays at Marathon the following Friday, March the 1st, here on Bow Falls Radio. The number 4 seed is Stratford. They get a first-round bye. They will wait for the winner of the game between number 12 Abbotsford and number 5 Washburn. Edgar is number 3 seeded in the bracket. They will take on either number 6 Iola Scandinavia or number 11 Shawamigan. And to make it a clean sweep of the top 4 seeds in that bracket in Division 4, Auburndale is seeded number 2. They will wait for the winner of number 7 Phillips and number 10 Spencer. So it could be a mini Marrowood Conference South Division tournament in that bracket with number 1 Marathon, number 2 Auburndale, number 3 Edgar, and number 4 Stratford. And then in Division 5, the Newman Catholic Cardinals, the defending state champions in Division 5, but obviously they lost all of their starters and most of their production from that great team from a year ago. And Newman Catholic will try to make a playoff run as a number 11 seed this year in their Division 5 bracket. They will travel to number 6 seeded White Lake next Tuesday night. Newman at White Lake a week from tomorrow. First round playoff game that will be broadcast live right here on Bow Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. BowFallsRadio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO. Also in the bracket, Northern Lutheran in that D5 sectional number 2. Northern Lutheran, the number 9 seed. They will travel to number 8 seeded Wild Rose next Tuesday night. The winner of that one will meet number 1 seeded Almon Bancroft in a regional semifinal. Other area teams in that D5 bracket, number 3 seeded Pacelli will host number 14 Gresham. The winner of that game will move on to face either number 11 Newman or number 6 White Lake in the regional semifinals. And basically, again, that's most of the teams from our area. You got Athens. Let's see, where is Athens in that boys' bracket in Division 5? They're not in the same sectional as Newman Catholic. The Athens Blue Jays are number 10 seeded in their sectional. Sectional number 1, they will travel to number 7 Prentice in the first round next Tuesday night. With a win, Athens would face either number 2 Drummond or number 15 Cornell in the following round. Girls basketball playoffs get underway tomorrow night. As I mentioned earlier, tomorrow night, another doubleheader of high school sports coverage. I will be with the Central Wisconsin Storm against Hayward in the girls hockey sectional semifinals, live here on Bow Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Tom Weaver will be in Marathon tomorrow night as the Red Raider girls will open up their playoff run against Ladysmith. So again, Ladysmith at Marathon tomorrow night. You can hear the game live on the Sports 2 stream of BowFallsRadio.com and the Civic Media app, starting with the pregame show at 6:45 and the opening tip-off at 7 p.m. Also, girls basketball tomorrow night. Not much going on tomorrow in the girls bracket because most of the teams start their playoff run on Friday in D1, but DC Everest, number 18 seed, has to play a first-round game at number 15-seeded Eau Claire North. So Everest at Eau Claire North tomorrow night in the first round of the playoffs. A win for Everest would allow them to travel to number 2-seeded Hudson coming up on Friday evening. Also tomorrow night in high school girls basketball playoff action, the Newman Catholic girls basketball team will be in action. Newman Catholic will be a number 10 seed. They travel to number 7 seeded Edgar. So a couple of Marrowood Conference South Division rivals in action tomorrow night. Newman Catholic and Edgar. The winner will take on either number 2 Pittsville or number 5 Iola Scandinavia. Also in that bracket, Northern Lutheran is a number 11 seed. The Wildcats travel to number 6 seeded Columbus Catholic. and number 4-seeded Athens tomorrow night, taking on number 13-seeded Marion. But it is such a very exciting time of the year in high school sports, and we are very happy to be bringing you all this action here on Wausau's only station that still provides live play-by-play of high school athletics with the Wausau West Warriors, the Newman Catholic Cardinals, and the Marathon Red Raiders. Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. And you can check out our upcoming broadcast schedule by going to our website, bullfallsradio.com/sports, as well. And we also have our previous broadcast of high school athletics found on that page as well. But again, very exciting time. We will find out what hockey teams are heading to state by the end of this week. We will have the first week of the girls basketball playoffs, and then we have conference championships being decided in boys basketball. Again, big battle for Marathon. Games tonight and Thursday. Have to win both if you're Marathon to get a solo Marrowwood Conference South championship. And we have both games tonight at Edgar, and then Thursday night, home versus Auburndale, live with the Marathon boys right here on Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230, bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO. The time is 9:48. It is the 19th day of February of 2024. Coming up next, we'll have our daily history lesson, let you know about some famous events that occurred on this date in history, some celebrity birthdays, and we're going to see if Ian can do better this week on the number for the day.
I certainly hope so.
Yeah, it was not a good week last week in that respect.
So no, it was not.
We're going to try to start off with a winner today with the number for the day coming up as we continue on this Monday morning, the Chad Holmes Show, Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230. I'm Chad Holmes. Join former Newman Catholic High School boys basketball coach Jeff Gress and myself each Wednesday from 6 until 8 p.m. for the Big High School Sports Show on Bull Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230, online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. We do nothing but talk high school sports for 2 hours every Wednesday night, plus special guests. Each Wednesday, we'll be joined by one of our area high school head coaches, plus a student-athlete guest as well. In addition, Jeff and I will break down what's going on in boys and girls high school basketball and boys and girls hockey in central Wisconsin. It's the Big High School Sports Show, every Wednesday night from 6 until 8 p.m. on Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230, bullfallsradio.com. Mobile devices and Alexa by searching WXCO, and on the Civic Media app. Plus, if you missed the show, just go to bullfallsradio.com/sports or wherever you get your podcasts. .9 here on this Monday morning. Chad Holmes, Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. Online at bullfallsradio.com, mobile devices, and Alexa by searching WXCO. The temperature warming up nicely, now up to 25 degrees. A little bit of sunshine, mostly cloudy skies, as we expect temperatures to warm up again very nicely as we get into the afternoon. It is the 19th day of February of 2024. That means we are up to day number 50. Day number 50 of this year. 316 days remaining in 2024. And some famous events have occurred on this date in history. Back on this date in 1982. One of the infamous moments for Ozzy Osbourne in a career full of infamous moments. On this date in 82, Ozzy Osbourne was arrested for urinating on the Alamo.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy is right. On this date in 1986, the Soviet Union launched the Mir space station. On this date in 2006, the Rolling Stones made the largest show open to the public of the world. that wording was bad. The Rolling Stones made the largest show, which was open to the public, at Copacabana Beach, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. 1.3 million people went to the show.
Wow.
I wonder about the parking for that one.
That was probably interesting.
On this date in 2008, Toshiba announced the end of HD-DVD, ending the format war between it and Sony's Blu-ray disc. On this date in 2016, presidential candidate Donald Trump told Fox News he probably needed to act more presidential and said he would do so pretty soon.
Probably, yeah.
He has not started acting more presidential 8 years later. And then 1 year ago today, 2023, Richard Belzer, stand-up comedian and actor who most recently found fame as Detective John Munch on Homicide: Life on the Street and Law & Order SVU, died. He was 78. Some famous people celebrating birthdays today. Smokey Robinson, legendary Motown star, 84 years old today. Actor Jeff Daniels, probably best known for his role in Dumb and Dumber, 69. Prince Andrew, disgraced Prince Andrew, Duke of York, 64 years old today. Singer Seal turned 61. Actor Justine Bateman of Family Ties, 58. Benicio Del Toro is 57. And Millie Bobby Brown from Stranger Things is 20 years old today. And if you out there celebrating your birthday, happy birthday to you from all of us at Bull Falls Radio, 98.9 and 1230. This week, some special events being acknowledged. It's National FFA Week. It is Bird Health Awareness Week, Eating Disorders Awareness Week, Engineers Week, also Justice for Animals Week, Invasive Species Awareness Week. It is also President's Day, so no mail today, International Tug of War Day, Iwo Jima Day, Chocolate Mint Day,
that sounds good,
Prevent Plagiarism Day, and Lash Day. All right. It is time.
All right.
Again, if you missed last week, 0 for 5.
Yeah.
Ian Welch was 0 for 5 last week.
I blame
on
the
our
tech
quiz
week for that.
I think that's as good of an excuse as any. But 0 for 5, that's hard to do because we give you three choices every day.
I still
multiple
get them
choices.
Wrong.
And then you missed all 5 days last week.
Yeah.
So you got some catching up to do here this week.
Yes, I do.
All right. All right. This is an actual interesting, very interesting number.
Okay.
Because I would never think of this. And this is interesting because the number for the day is the number of seconds that will tick off in the year 2024.
Number of seconds.
And there's a few more seconds this year because it's a leap year.
Right. Okay.
So I'm going to give you three choices.
All right.
21,422,300. 31,622,400.
Oh, boy.
42,622,400. So basically, 21 million plus, 31 million plus, 41 million plus.
You know, I'm just going to...
The number of seconds
okay.
in 2024.
I'm just going to trust my gut as well. I'm going to go C.
41 million...
I'm going to say the biggest number.
41,622,400.
This is a leap year. Be more seconds, so it makes sense.
The correct answer is B. 31,622,400 seconds in 2024.
Dang, that's not how I wanted to start
just,
on Monday.
Just for your information, In non-leap years, there are 31,536,000 seconds. So 31,622,400 in leap years, 31,536,000. All right, 0 for 1. It's still early in the week.
So early.
We'll do it again tomorrow. Don't forget tomorrow. Join me from 6 till 8, guest hosting Up North News Radio, Nancy Stencil at 6:20, 7th District Congress candidate Kyle Kilborn at 7:35, and then I'll be back from 8 till 10 as well for this program here on Bow Falls Radio. So, Ian, have a good Monday.
You too. Happy Monday, everybody.
And stick around. Matt and Air on Air coming up next here on Bow Falls Radio 98.9 and 1230.